to you, Lenora Alexander. Lenora, I'm sure your daughter is amazingly proud of you. And most importantly, I think all of you deserve to give her an answer if her daughter's less likely to die. Lenora?
Thank you, and good morning. And I'm Lenora Alexander, I'm Leah Sufol's mother. It's taken me 10 years to tell the story. Leah died on December 15th, 10 years ago. I agreed to be here today because I believe Joe Chiani, I believe Peter Pronovost, and I believe all of you here. And I believe each of you are here because you want to make a change, to change a culture that's accepting more than 200,000 deaths annually, and to start to make the changes necessary to prevent them. I believe that's what brought each of you here today, and I know that's why I'm here. Peter Pronovost tells that heart-wrenching story of Josie King, and he speaks with well-earned pride about the years it took to finally be able to tell Josie's mother that because of all the self-evaluation and all the changes he made and his team made, 18-month-old Josie would not die today at Hopkins. My truth is different. The way my daughter died 10 years ago, she would die today, just as likely. And I think of all the families that have been torn apart and broken by the tragedy of losing a child. And that's because most things have not changed. We're not doing enough things differently. So Dr. Pronovost says we can't rely on heroes, and I agree. And that change starts with accepting our own humanity. After all, we're only human, and as humans, we can't expect it to be perfect. There will always be glitches, imperfect understanding of scribbled notes and nurses who can't make the midnight check of vital signs and doctors who sometimes just can't answer a page. All of these contributed to Leah's death. And there are human anomalies that will almost certainly contribute to another death, probably today. I don't come here to blame. I know it's never anyone's intent to harm a patient, but it's not intent that's the problem. All the good intentions in the world don't count for much when you wake up and your daughter's dead in bed next to you. So why am I here and what do I want? I want a standard of care that adapts to human imperfection. And it uses the existing technology to create a new standard of safety, and that lets clinicians live out their good intentions 200,000 more times every year. That night at the hospital, I didn't know I needed to be ready to save Leah's life. I didn't know she needed protection, but she did, just like airline passengers needed protection. And the aviation industry developed checklists, and they saved lives. And when medicine adopts checklists, medical checklists save lives. I don't pretend to know the components of a newer, smart, safer way of using all these devices to improve patient safety. But I know, and I know all of you know, one thing that would have saved Leah's life. A monitor would have saved my child's life. And so, in loving memory of my wonderful daughter, Leah, and because I know she would have expected this of me, her mommy, I've made the goal of continuous post-operative monitoring my commitment. All that stands between us and universal post-op monitoring is the will to require it. And the fact that monitors can save hundreds of children from dying in their hospital beds demands that we all find the will to require it. I'll work as long as it takes to see that Leah's law requiring continuous monitoring becomes standard of care. And I hope many of you will join me in this. I'm so encouraged to see all of you here knowing on the other side of these speeches there are real solutions and there are real plans and concrete ideas that you can implement immediately. I didn't choose to become a safety advocate. Life forced this on me. But I'm proud to be here and to be part of this summit, this movement. This is a really promising start. And I hope you'll give thought to Leah as you attend these sessions today. And when you leave here tonight, please hold her memory as I do and make that memory a blessing for the next child that's placed in your care. I really thank you all for being here.